Students, today we are going to see some important questions related on our first poem, A Teenager's Prayer. The first question, choose the correct alternative and complete the given sentences. First, A, according to the poet, dash 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 are brought by each new day. The options are new beginnings and new endings. Let us see the answer from the poem. Each day brings new beginnings. New beginnings, this word is important. So here the answer is new beginnings. Second sentence, we must decide to take the road which leads to dash dash dash. Two options, great distress, great success. Now here we must decide, that means the poet has to decide the road. Let us see the poem. The poet says, I can choose to take the road of life that leads to great success. So great success, this is the answer. So we write here the answer, great success. The third sentence, C, the poet prays to the Lord to help him stand for what is, and the two options are might and right. Here in this line, the poet says, help me stand for what is right. What is right? This is the answer. So the word right is the answer. The fourth sentence, the poet wants to see that his teenage years have been the dash 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 years of his life. Two options, worst, best. In this line, the life is lived its very best. We get the answer, the best. So here, the answer is best. Question number two, find and write the pairs of rhyming words from the poem. Here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. These are the numbers of the stanzas. Now we will see the first stanza. This is the first stanza. In this first stanza, you will see that make and take, the two highlighted words, they are rhyming words. We write here make and take. Second stanza, see the rhyming words in third stanza, which are the four words, last four words, Lord, see, write and me, Lord, see, write and me. So C and me rhyme with each other. C and me. Now see the fourth stanza. Look at the fourth stanza. Which are the last words in each line? No, way, clean and day. Which words rhyme here? Way and day. So we will write the words way and day. Now see the fifth and last stanza. In the last stanza, we will see the last words over, see, best and me. Which words rhyme with each other? See and me. So we will write these words, see and me. See and me. In this way, we have written the rhyming words from the poem. Now next question. Question number three, what is the rhyme scheme of the poem? Choose the correct one from the following options. Now, in the previous video, I have told you how to write the rhyme scheme. Again, we will see how to write the rhyme scheme. See carefully. Now, see carefully. The first word from this poem, first last word, beginnings. We mark this word as A. Then second word, make, we mark it as B. The third word, we mark it as C. And the fourth word, we mark it as B, because make and take, these two highlighted words, they rhyme with each other. So the word beginnings, we mark it as A. The second word make, we mark it as B. The third word choose, we mark it as C. The fourth word take, we mark it as B again, because it rhymes with make. So make is marked as B and take is also marked as B. So the rhyme scheme is, look here, A, B, C, B. In this way, the rhyme scheme is A, B, C, B. So the answer of this question is A, B, C, B. This is our answer. Question number 4. Match the lines in column A with the figures of speech in column B. The two columns are given, column A and column B. In column A, the lines from the poem are given, and in column B, the names of figures of speech are given. Let us see carefully. The first in column A, decisions I must make. Decisions I must make. In this line, we see that the sequence is changed. The sentence should be, I must make decisions. So this decision word, it is taken at the first place. So this figure of speech is inversion. This figure of speech is inversion. Decisions I must make, the figure of speech is inversion. Now, second, please open up my eyes, dear Lord. Please open up my eyes, dear Lord. Please open up my eyes, dear Lord. Here, the poet directly talks with the God. Therefore, the figure of speech is apostrophe. See the third, travel down the darkened road. Observe this line. What do you find here? Travel down the darkened road. Travel down the darkened road. Do you think a particular sound is repeated here? Which sound is repeated? Let us see. See the sound D that comes again and again. Down, darkened, road. The word down begins with D. The word darkened begins with D. Therefore, the figure of speech here is alliteration. The fourth line, I can choose to take the road of life. Here, the life is a road. Therefore, this figure of speech is metaphor. Now we will see more about alliteration. Alliteration is the occurrence of the same sound at the beginning of words in a phrase, sentence, etc. Such as, that life is lived its very best. Here, this L is repeated here again in lived. Life, lived. Life and lived. So the L sound comes again and again. So the figure of speech is alliteration. Do you understand what is alliteration? Now find out more examples of alliteration from other poems in your book. Now we will see the appreciation of the poem. This question is very important for board exam. The points in appreciation of poem are title, poet, rhyme scheme, favorite line, theme, or that is also called as central idea, figures of speech. The title. Title of this poem is Teenager's Prayer. This is the title, A Teenager's Prayer. This title you have to write carefully. This is the name of the poet, J. Morse. Name of poet at the end of the poem. You have to write it. So we have written the title, Teenager's Prayer, poet J. Morse. Write this very, very carefully. Rhyme scheme. As previously we have seen, the rhyme scheme is A, B, C, B. Favorite lines. You have to write the favorite lines according. Write the favorite lines according to your own opinion. Which lines do you like most? Write those lines here. Now, theme or central idea. Central idea of this poem. In this point, you have to write what you understand from this poem. See, in this poem, the speaker is a teenager. The teenager wants to get success in his or her life. The teenager requests God to open up his or her eyes. The teenager knows that this age is going to be the best period in life and God is always with him or her. Now, figures of speech. We have studied alliteration, metaphor, apostrophe and inversion. You can write any one from these figures of speech. Now, pause this video, read the poem once again, try solving these questions on your own and practice regularly. Thank you, and then see the upcoming videos.